So we just saw that the condition for continuity of a function at a particular point x equals to a function if left hand limit is equal to right hand limit is equal to the function value of a. And you know that this was the condition which proves that limit exists. So now we go a step ahead and we also check the functional value at a to prove that the function is continuous at a particular point x equals to a. Now, since you know the condition for continuity of a function at a particular point x equals to a, now you tell me what are the cases for which a function can be discontinuous. What are the cases in which a function can be discontinuous? Okay, let's go by the definition to find the answer. This was a condition for a function to be continuous at a particular point x equals to a. Now the first condition which can happen is that left hand limit is not equal to right hand limit. Obviously, if this is not equal to left hand limit is not equal to right hand limit, that means what? That means the limit itself doesn't exist. So the function is discontinuous at the particular point x equals to a. An example for this could be, let's say I have a function Let's say this is the graph of my function. Here you can see that the left hand limit is equal to L2. The right hand limit is equal to L1. And the functional value is also equal to L1. So this condition is not satisfied and the function is discontinuous. Obviously you can graphically see that I have to lift my pen to draw the whole graph. So the function is discontinuous. And also it has a gap or a hole at this point. There's a big gap here. So this function is discontinuous. Now the second condition, which could prove that a function is discontinuous, is that this is equal to this, but this is not true. When can that case arise? That case can arise when you have a function like this. Obviously, you can see that the limiting value at this point is equal to L1, but the functional value is equal to this value, which is equal to L2. So L1 is not equal to L2, so the function is discontinuous. Again, you can see that you have a hole at this point. So graphically, you can easily say that the function is discontinuous at this point. Okay, so this was a brief concept about continuity of a function. Now let's take one or two examples where we need to check for the function being continuous at a particular point or not. The first example is your fx is square minus 1. But x minus 1, and you need to discuss the continuity at x equals to 1. Now when you are given questions like this, the first thing which you could do is that either you draw the graph, because graph will clearly tell you whether the function is continuous or not, or you can prove it mathematically. So let's do it first by the way of graphs. The graph of f of x can be drawn like this. You see that this function can be factorized at like this. And now if x is not equal to 1, then this comes out as x plus 1. for x not equal to 1. Okay, so this is my graph of the function. Now you can see that the graph is clearly not defined at x equals to 1, but the limit exists for x equals to 1. The limiting value is 2. If you are trying to find the limiting value as x approaches 1, since x is not equal to 1, I can cancel x minus 1 factor, so I am left with x plus 1. If you put x equals to 1, I'll get 2. So the limit exists. The left hand limit is equal to right hand limit is equal to 2. But since f of 1 is of the form 0 by 0, f of 1 is not defined, that means though limit exists, is not equal to f of 1, that means limit doesn't exist. Sorry, that means the function is not continuous at this point. Now, let's take another example.